Very good morning, dear students. This video is for class 10th subject science, chapter number 5, periodic classification of elements, and this is lecture number 7, part 2. In part 1, we have done the summary of chapter number 5, and in this part 2, we will see the assignment questions of assignment number 2 of chapter number 5, and we will also solve the homework questions of lecture number 6. Assignment number 2, which is a post-text assignment, having questions 11 in number, and the first question is, write a brief note on Daubernier's triodes with its limitations. Second question is, what is Newlyn's law of octaves? What advantages it has on Daubernier's triodes? Question number 3 is, what is the Mendeleev's periodic law? Question number 4, what is the law on which modern periodic table is based? Question number 5 is, what are S, P, D and F blocks so named in the modern periodic table? Question number 6 is, why should the physical and chemical properties be more dependent on the atomic number than the atomic mass? Question number 7 is, write short notes on the following: A. Electronegativity, B. Electron affinity, C. Ionization energy. Then question number 8 is, why are there 18 groups in the modern periodic table? Question number 9 is, why are there 2 groups in S block, 6 in P block, 10 in D block and 14 in F block in the modern periodic table? Question number 10 is, how do the following vary along a period and why? So this is about the trends in the modern periodic table. A. Metallic properties, B. Atomic size, C. Electronegativity, D. Electron affinity, E. Ionization energy. Question number 11 is, how do the following vary down a group and why? Metallic properties, atomic size, electronegativity, electron affinity and ionization energy. So this was our assignment number 2. Now let us see the homework questions of lecture number 6. Question number 1 is, the position of 3 elements A, B and C in the periodic table are shown here. A. State whether A is a metal or non-metal. B. State whether C is more reactive or less reactive than A. C. Will C be larger or smaller than B? Which type of ion, cation or anion, will be formed by element A? So let us begin with the first part. State whether A is a metal or non-metal. So as you can see here that group 16 and 17, they both belong to the non-metals. So for sure A is a non-metal. So the answer to the part A is that an element A is a non-metal. We know why, because group number 17 is having element A. And we know that according to the position of the element, if it is in 17th group, then its valence electrons will be 7 in number, and 7 in number, that means they are placed, they are electronegative in nature. That is why we can say that element A is non-metal, because metals are electropositive in nature. Only electronegative element is a non-metal. Then the second question was, state whether C is more reactive or less reactive than A. Here you can understand the C is below A. And while studying the trends in the periodic table, we have studied that as we go down in the group, the reactivity decreases. That is why we can say that C is more less reactive than A. Why? Because as we go down in the group, the size increases and the nuclear charge per electron also decreases. Therefore, the reactivity of the element becomes less. So the answer is C is less reactive than A. C is which will C be larger or smaller in size than B? So here itself you can say that B is in 16th group and C is in the 17th group. So as we move across the periods from B to C, we know that nuclear charge per electron increases. As when we go from left to right in a period, then number of shells are not increasing, but number of electrons in the last occupied shell are increasing by 1. That means now more number of protons are there to take care of the electrons. So nuclear charge per electron increases. Instead of increase in size, the force of attraction between the protons and the electrons increases, which causes the decrease in the size as we go from left to right in the period. Therefore, C will be smaller in size than B. Part D is which type of ion, cation or anion, will be formed by the element A. So as we have discussed that A is a non-metal, so it will form an ion only. Question number 2 is nitrogen having atomic number 7 and phosphorus atomic number 15 belong to group 15 of the periodic table. Write the electronic configuration of these two elements. Which of these will be more electronegative and why? And the answer is that atomic number of nitrogen is 7. So its electronic configuration will be 2, 5. Atomic number of phosphorus is 15, so electronic configuration of phosphorus will be 2, 8 and 5. That means both have 5 electrons in their outermost occupied shell. But nitrogen is more electronegative than phosphorus. Why? Because the attraction between the nucleus and the electrons becomes weaker as we go down in the group. That is why electronegativity, which is the tendency to share, to attract the electrons, it is decreasing as we go down in the group. And this way we can say that nitrogen is more electronegative than phosphorus. Question number 3 is, how does the electronic configuration of an atom relate to its position in the modern periodic table? And the answer is that it mainly depends on the quantum number or shell number and the orbitals. The element which are having same shell number are placed in the same period, and the elements which are having different quantum numbers but having same valence electrons in the outermost shell are placed in the same group. For example, let an atom or molecule have atomic number 17. Electronic configuration will be 2, 8 and 7. So it has 3 shells and 7 electrons in its outermost shell. So valence electrons are 7 in number and there are 3 shells. So this will be placed in third period. And as 7 electrons are there in its valency shell, so how to calculate the group number? 10 plus the number of valence electrons. So it will be in the 17th group and third period. So this is how we calculate the position of the atom or molecule in a modern periodic table. Question number 4 is, In a modern periodic table, calcium, atomic number 20, is surrounded by element with the atomic numbers 12, 19, 21. Which of these have physical and chemical properties resembling calcium? So we know that physical and chemical properties are because of the number of valence electrons. If the valence electrons are same, then the properties will be similar. So the element with the atomic number 12 has the same physical and chemical properties as that of calcium. You know why? Because the element with the atomic number 12 is magnesium, which is having atomic number 12. So its electronic configuration will be 2, 8 and 2. This way you can see it here that calcium is having atomic number 20. So its electronic configuration will be 2, 8, 8, 2. It is also having valence electrons, 2 valence electrons in its outermost shell. And the element which is magnesium is also having electronic configuration 2, 8 and 2. So, 2 electrons are there in the valence electrons. So, magnesium that is having atomic number 12 will have the similar properties as that of calcium. Question number 5 is, compare and contrast the arrangement of elements in Mendeley's periodic table and modern periodic table. And the answer is, first comparison between them is, elements are arranged in increasing order of their atomic masses, whereas in modern periodic table, elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic numbers. Mendeley's periodic table, there are 8 groups and 6 periods, although there were 7, but the 7th was completely blank. But in modern periodic table, there are 18 groups and 7 periods. Mendeley's periodic table, elements having similar properties were placed directly under one another. Elements having same valency or same valence electrons are present in the groups, and the elements have number of shells equal. They are present in the same periods. Mendeley's periodic table, here there is no position for the metals and non-metals. But in modern periodic table, metals are present at the left side of the modern periodic table and non-metals are present at the right side of the periodic table. In the Mendeley's periodic table, more than one element kept in one slot. But in modern periodic table, only one element is kept in each slot. So, this is how you can compare and contrast Mendeley's periodic table with the modern periodic table. So, this is it for this lecture. Now, with this, we are ending up with the chapter number 5 and we are now onwards going to start with the physics portion of class number for class 10th. So, the chapter which we are going to start next is electricity. So, be ready with it, and also with this assignment, you have to prepare for a test of chapter number 5 that will be taken on 22nd of May. So, all the best for that and take care. Goodbye.